the Ebony J show is happening right now. A Real Talk News meets real people. And I am standing right here with the TV personality, fashion expert, creative director. I mean, this girl does it all. What is going on?
Go-Go
Atkins. Oh my goodness. It's crazy to be standing with you. It is such a pleasure. Now, what are you up to? Like, so many different things you have going on. So many hats you're balancing. What can we expect that's coming up right now?
Well, the latest, I just wish Essence Festival, I can show
you
from there.
You say I'm more soon in life.
And then I'm pushing another single for Style this month. I'm not sure if it's coming out. But yeah, another single for Style. After that.
Hold on. You just left the festival. You gotta tell me, how was that?
Oh, amazing. I've been to the festival pretty much every year for like the past 10 years or so. I think I skipped 1 year. But, 11 years, because I skipped the year that it was at, that right after Katrina when they had it like in Houston. Mm-hmm. I skipped that year. But anyway, a good time as always. Just a wonderful time with grown, nice,
just be turned the energy. I saw some of it on James Fortune. He was having it on Periscope. I was like, oh my goodness, that was so amazing. Now you've been going to him so much. What has been your favorite one so far?
I don't know that I have a favorite one. I mean, you just have just really good. This year was really special because Essence actually booked me this year to speak at their event. Different entities, you know, companies and hair, makeup, beauty companies, you know, they booked me to be a part of their event, hosts and so on and so forth. A book club that just gets books for girls. Their first year in college, they've been booking me every year for the past 5 or 6 years. They booked me, but this year Essence actually booked me to do a fashion beauty expert on one of their stages there. So that was pretty, you know, exciting.
Girl, you can work with so many great people. I mean, Lisa Gray, like, oh my goodness, working with so many different people. Do you even have like someone that you love to have the best? Everybody has different shades, different colors.
You know what, the thing is, I like people that let me do what I do and that trust me. And you know, of course I respect people's opinions and everything, but sometimes it can kind of conflict with their creativity when they're kind of, I need this, I want it to be this, and I'm just, in those instances, it's just like, you know what, you really deserve this. You really should have just hired your personal assistant to go to the store and get what it is you want. But when you hire a creative person, let them be creative, you know? And so those are the clients I usually gel the best in.
And then you have your show, The Room. So with that show, is that a way for us to get that inside scoop on what we should expect?
Just, you know, I'm not a blogger. I actually don't speak fashion. A lot of the names of the trends, I don't know them. I don't follow them with that stuff. I just know. Well, I don't think you have to know that stuff to know what you're doing. Just like you don't have to go to music school to know how to sing.
Right.
You just know how to sing. So it's just like, I have a fashion, so I actually know how to school magazines and all that stuff. I just know how to make people look good. I'm listening to give. And so that's what I do on my show. I let them know all those fancy words. I don't know what that means, all those French words. I don't know what all that means. I speak English, and to me, this is a red top.
Right.
You know, you want to call it magenta and crimson. I'm like, this one's red. They come into the crayon box, and those are the ones that I'm
white.
Light red, dark red. Light purple, dark purple. All the colors I love. And I think that works for the everyday world because they don't either. Sometimes the fashion game, and you know, just any game, you want to sound fancy and have this forever. But sometimes that can cause you to disconnect from just the everyday parents. I just kind of style on camera pretty much. I explain why I picked what I picked and that whole sort of thing. And I want to fancy stuff because that's not really how I talk or how I work.
And you even show from them, this is what I'm going to do. She's pressing it.
I wanted a showroom because I wanted to house my clothes.
Okay.
And I want to have a place to have my fittings. It's real cute, so I also have small parties and stuff there. Like an event space. Because I'm not there every day. It's appointment only. You have to pay for an appointment. Because sometimes, people want to come through and they want to hang out. They don't realize I don't get paid for that.
Right.
So basically, it's for red carpet and events. Your celebrity client or so-and-so is just come in and do some clothes for them. That's fine, but it's not open to the public. It's not a store where you can buy clothes. It's where you can stylists can come and pull clothes for their events, for their red carpet events.
That's great, and such a good idea. I've been following you on social media. Tell the people where they can go follow
Well, I just say what, you know what, I don't feel the need to do this overly nice thing because I feel like I am nice. And if you don't think so, oh well, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So when I got to say no or when I got to, you know, make you aware of my boundaries, I'm fine with that too. Because
right.
I love art too, so, you know. But anyway, my social media is TheGoogoo, TheGoogoo, on everything.
Everything. And my favorite thing of the week is Friday because you put on one for the BBW.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it's just so many, you know what, so many people come to my page with what's where, and I have a certain body type that other people may not have, so I was thinking I would have put them on my page so people could see how other people have different complexions, different body types, ages, you know, different ethnicities, and so, you know, what are they wearing? Fabulous is fabulous, and so I post pictures of all the fabulous plus size ladies. Hopefully it makes them feel inspired, it makes them feel beautiful, and just to give my followers, you know, new ideas of, oh, look how this person is doing it, they're fly also.
You pick and choose.
Well, when you add the hashtag, people like to DM me pictures, they like to do this big tagging thing. I'm like, don't do any of that because I probably won't pick you if you do that. Just if you have a picture on social media, go up under the picture and in the comments just put hashtag ghouls. Full Figure Friday, no S. Put that under the picture and automatically when I search that hashtag, I'll see it.
Okay, well thank you so much for just speaking with me. It's been a great event here. I'm so glad to have you here.